Today, supersonic flight is actually prohibited over land in the U.S. and across the world, actually. And so NASA is hoping to enable future supersonic flight over land.
What we're interested in is making a model of how to predict how annoyed people are going to be by different sonic boom sounds. And we need to know whether we need to include structural vibrations in that model. And that's what we're trying to find out in this test. We're testing a total of 33 people. The subjects are from the Hampton Roads community. In some tests, we use recordings that we've made from field tests using existing supersonic aircraft flying special maneuvers. But in this test, we're using all synthetic or predicted sonic booms. The sounds are predictions that are made from computer models of the aircraft, the future aircraft that are likely to generate them. And the vibration signals we get from computer models of buildings and how they would respond to these acoustic signals. This room was designed to mimic a corner room of a detached home. There are 52 subwoofers and 52 mid-range loudspeakers that are mounted just outside the exterior walls. And when we replay the signals over those loudspeakers, the signal transmits through the wall just like it would in a real home. The Adirondack chairs look like they don't fit in the living room. And the reason we use them is because they are rigid chairs, so they transmit the vibration directly from the shaker to the subject that's seated in the chair.
You need the laboratory studies to determine what kind of metric you would use to correlate with the actual kind of annoyance data that the people would be providing.
The goal is to build aircraft with sonic booms that are so quiet that they're acceptable, and that appears to be within our capabilities.